Welcome to Conscious Coupling, where Frederick Gobet and Christy Whitman share their experiences of creating a conscious, connected relationship. Every week, they give practical tools, steps, and processes to help you find the loving connection with your partner. Let's get into today's conversation with Frederick and Christy.
What if I invest all that money and it's not really worth it?
What if I ask for what I want and I don't get it?
All these what ifs.
So, let's use what if to our advantage. We are not paid actors and actresses. So we are talking about what if today. A lot of times we in our heads will think, well, what if I want to go on a couples retreat and I ask my husband and he says he doesn't want to go? Well, what if you ask him and he says he does want to go? What if I, you know, share how I do feel and I'm not heard? What if I go into couples coaching with him and nothing changes? And now, what if the relationship ends? What if I can't make my relationship better? What if things just completely stay the same? What if things don't improve? A lot of times we're so focused on what we don't want or what we're fearing in our relationships. So fear and also lack is driving our what ifs.
And your what ifs don't have all the right answers.
Right. And what if you change your what ifs to what you actually do want? Because we could either go one of two ways. We could go what if, and then think of all the things that we don't want, all the things that could go wrong, all the things that we fear, all the places that we're just gonna be disappointed and, you know, we're not gonna have what we want, all that kind of stuff. Or we can pivot and say, what if, and think about our desires. What if your desire came true? What if you actually invested in the relationship, whether it was time, money, energy, whatever, and it actually improved? What if you actually started dreaming about the places that you wanted to travel? And what if you actually got to create the money to go on those vacations or created the time to do it? It's time to start looking at your what ifs towards what you desire and what you want instead of what you don't. Because a lot of times in our heads, we think about the what ifs and they're usually not what we want to ponder. Remember with law of attraction, what you focus on expands. What you're putting your focus, your attention, your mindset, your thoughts, your beliefs, your words, your actions, all of that matters because all of it is vibration and you are a vibrational being in a vibrational universe. So as you start to catch yourself silently saying to yourself, well, what if? Change it to, well, what if? Like, what if my dreams came true? What if I had everything I want? What if I had the most intimate, loving relationship with my partner?
What if I had all the possibilities in any aspect of my life, right? So our brain keeps us in the fear of the what ifs. So if you kind of recognize that, oh, okay, this is my brain that's keeping me in the fear space of what if I can't have that? Well, what if there's the possibility of looking at if you can, yes, have that? That's where you need to do the work.
Absolutely. So, for this week, we are giving you a little challenge to look at places to be mindful, connected enough with yourself, inside of yourself, to think about the what ifs. What have you been what ifing inside of your own head? What have you been what-ifing about your partner that you don't even know? Because a lot of times we make assumptions. Well, what if I bring this to him and he won't be receptive? What if he is? Or what if she is? So think about what are the things that you've been censoring yourself or not expressing yourself in the way you want to and not asking for what you want because you feel you're going to be rejected because in your mind's telling you that that what if is going to be a bad thing or there's something to fear or it's not going to turn out the way you want. Really look at that. Really think about those things. Be mindful of that. And then as you think of them, shift it to, well, what if it turned out better than I could have imagined? That's a question you want to ask yourself. If you hear yourself going down that road of, well, what if he just rejects me? But what if I tell him who I am and express who I am and accepts me more than I ever, I'm more loved than I've ever been. I'm more understood than I've ever been. What if that happens? So start changing your what ifs inside of yourself, because as you change your relationship to your what ifs inside of yourself, you're changing your relationship to everything outside, because everything is a direct reflection of what's going on inside you. And that even means those silent conversations that you have to yourself that you don't even tell your best friend about. The what ifs inside, as you are pivoting, because everything's energy, as you're pivoting that energy to possibilities, to potentiality, to desires, to dreams, to, you know, goal fulfillment, to the things that you would absolutely love in all aspects of your life, to truly having it all, start to spend more time thinking about those what ifs.
And that's how you become in the space of creativity. When you're staying in the space of the what if with all the possibilities, with all of that, all of what you desire, I mean, you become more creative. You then see all of the, you know, beautiful aspects of your life that can work, that can be positive for you, that can be beneficial.
Well, and that's true, because when you're in the what if of the positivity, you're in abundance and you're aligned. The divine partner that you have, your true life partner that you have, is always looking for what's growth, what's expansion, what can we put our hands into and play with, and what can we desire and create together, because the desire, the divine is a creator, and it creates through you as an individual container. And so when you're in the what if and you're saying, what if that doesn't work out, your divine self doesn't think that way. So you're now misaligned, you're detached from your creative mind, from your divine connection. And but when you shift and you're saying, what if it worked out better? What if it was fun? What if I received love? What if I got what I wanted? Now you're in alignment with your divine self, and that energy is flowing towards what you do want, and you're not creating what you don't want. So you're feeling even more alive because you're connected with the greater part of who you are. So watch your what ifs. They're hugely important. And here's an exercise for you to take away for today. Now, it takes 17 seconds to shift a vibration based on Abraham Hicks's research. It takes 68 seconds to actually shift the law of attraction, for the law of attraction to kick in and start giving you a very different vibration. So take your phone out, and for 68 seconds, literally 68 seconds, I'm gonna do this with you right now. I am gonna time you, so we are gonna just do this together. You are going to, where the heck is my timer thing? You are gonna say what you want for 68 seconds. And you're gonna say all the what ifs towards the positives. And we're gonna play along with you too. But for right now, I'm gonna time you. We're gonna do it for 68 seconds. Think of all the things that you would want and more, and you're gonna be surprised what else comes out. So here you go, go. What if we went on that amazing vacation to New Zealand? What if we went on another amazing cruise with the kids? And what if we took them out of school for a couple of weeks? And what if we went to Bali? And what if we went to, oh my gosh, if we went to Austria and climbed the hill that Julie Andrews sang The Sound of Music on top of that mountain? And what if we got to see where the whole thing was filmed in that cemetery and all of that kind of stuff? And what if we became even more successful than we've ever wanted, and we got to build a house in Silverleaf? What if my mom and dad lived forever? What if?
What if our kids were going to listen to us
all the time,
every time that we asked them to,
without any questions? Yes, mom. Yes, dad. What if we could just have peace and harmony in our life in all of our relationships? What if things always turned out the way we wanted them to? That's it. So did you do your what ifs? How do you feel? You can't spend 68 seconds thinking about what you want and how great it would feel and feel bad. But if you spend 68 seconds thinking about all the things that could go wrong, you will feel bad. Mm-hmm. So it's your choice. If you do this every single day for at least 68 seconds, that's a minute and 8 seconds. Right?
A minute and 8 seconds per day. That's not a lot.
That's nothing.
And we're supposed to brush our teeth longer than that.
For 2 minutes.
Just 2 minutes.
Right? So what if you set a timer and you did that morning, afternoon, and evening, and you just revved up your energy by talking about the possibilities, the what-ifs in your life, the what-ifs in your relationship? What do you think your relationship would do?
What do you think your life would be like? I mean, let yourself be surprised by the outcome in your life. That's often people need to control what's going on, control that fear, right? But let yourself be surprised. Let yourself be engaged into what the universe has to offer to you.
But you have to be a vibrational match to be on that level of surprise and delight in order to receive it. So doing this exercise will help you get in the be in the vibrational place with that. So I hope you enjoyed this podcast today. Next week, we are actually going to be talking about something that's a really important subject, and that's the pain body versus the light body. So we are excited to have you invite. We have a couple more spots left for the couples retreat in February. So if you are interested in deepening your connection with your partner, taking some time, intimate time in a beautiful place in Carefree, Arizona, we just suggest you go to christywhitman.com/couples. Couples.
And we hope that you appreciated the what-ifing,
yes,
new word that came up out of Christy's dictionary today. Have a good week.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks for listening to Conscious Coupling with Frederick Gobay and Christy Whitman. If you like our show and want to know more, check out christywhitman.com. And please leave us a review on iTunes. Learn how to turn your partner into your soulmate. Join us again next week for another powerful episode.